Hello, and welcome to the View from Sibos 2023 video series, which tracks all the hot topics at the conference in Toronto, Canada, under the umbrella theme of collaborative finance in a fragmented world. I'm Joy Macknight, editor of The Banker, and I'm leaving London ahead of the conference to go to SWIFT's headquarters in Belgium to talk to CEO Javier Pérez-Tasso about all the hot topics he thinks will be discussed at the conference this year. Thanks so much for joining me, Javier.
Thank you, Joy. Thank you for coming, and always a pleasure to discuss with you.
So the last time we got together, you were talking a lot about fragmentation, and obviously now it's the main theme within Sibos this year. You know, how do you think that issue has evolved?
Well, fragmentation, I have to say, is very much part of every conversation that we have these days, that I'm having with our customers, all of our stakeholders. There are policymakers, regulators, and it is the case because of course it's been driven by the current geopolitical situation, geopolitical shifts that are having an impact on the way economies operate with each other, and obviously affecting global trade. But it's also led to a massive technological innovation that we see around us: big tech players, new technologies, fintechs, new forms of value such as CBDCs and tokenization of assets are clearly disrupting the way we operate in financial services. And it's also having an effect on international transactions, which is, by the way, been a focus area for the G20 for the past few years. So definitely it's one of the topics that will be heavily discussed at Sibos.
Excellent. And then you mentioned the G20, and obviously the G20 has set these quite ambitious targets when it comes to cross-border payments. And again, I think that's going to be a hot topic at Sibos.
Yeah.
How do you think that's progressing? And then what is the SWIFT community doing? And how is it playing a part in driving that forward?
Well, it's been progressing really well since 2019. And there is strong momentum in the industry towards the 2027 targets in terms of cost, speed, transparency, choice, and access. So, for example, if you look at speed, you know, the target is that by 2027, 75% of all international payments reach end beneficiary accounts within an hour. So if you take the SWIFT community, we are already at 89% of all transactions in the SWIFT network reaching end beneficiary banks within an hour. And almost half of all these transactions reaching and beneficiary accounts within 5 minutes. So we're well on the way to reach this very ambitious target. And same in terms of cost. The SWIFT community is clearly focused in reducing cost across the industry. And that is essentially, at the end of the day, by taking out friction from international transactions. And this is being done very successfully with data services such as pre-validation of payment information, account validity, but as well case management and screening services, to name a few. And of course, a very important area of focus going forward is anomaly detection, which is going to take, you know, the type of data services yet to another level. So it's clear an area that the SWIFT community, together with the investments that the community has done on ISO 22002, which have the potential to automate even further the flows and bring up new rich data that can even improve services to our customers. And that, together with all the work done on traceability of transactions, the transparency of transactions end to end, and by the way, not only in payments, but also in securities, with Securities View, that is leveraging a lot of the great work done by the industry on SWIFT GPI to make sure that securities instructions can be tracked end to end. And that has the potential of drastically reduced settlement fails. So great progress by the G20 as a whole and the SWIFT community, as we'll see it, but many more to come in the next 4 years towards these 2027 targets.
Excellent. The other thing I wanted to ask you about is interoperability, which has been another hot topic over the past few Siboses, and I know it will be again. Sort of, what are the things that you're working on now around interoperability?
Well, interoperability, it's a word, a buzzword, actually, that has been there for decades now. Actually, SWIFT's reason of existence has always been interoperability. Interoperability of economies, actually connect more than 200 countries, and particularly their payments and securities infrastructures with each other, always with financial institutions playing a front and center role. And now we could say that interoperability probably is, we're moving into a new era, interoperability of any forms of value, whether it is CBDCs in the payment space or actually tokenization of assets in the security space, which is an area where we're focusing extremely on when it comes to proof of concepts and sandboxes that we'll be sharing progress with the community as we move along. Because that is clearly part of the how interoperability can play out going forward. But there is another angle to interoperability as well, which is the fact that there is a multiplicity of networks and systems that coexist to make sure that these economies can interoperate. And what SWIFT is doing is embracing all of these new innovations, actually from incumbents or new players coming to the international sphere. And that's why we are working hand in hand with many of them. And there will be some announcements made at Sibos in that regard. But we're working with many of them in both allowing them to take advantage of all the data services that we have developed over the past few years when it comes to anomaly detection services, pre-validation services, traceability and tracking services, but also or making sure that we can provide data integrity end-to-end for the end customer, regardless of the network that is being used, whether the payment is initiated in SWIFT and ends up in another platform or vice versa. So a lot on that front, and again, yes, a big topic for Sibos.
Excellent. So my last question is really, Sibos is such a big conference and there's so much going on. What do you think we should be looking out for?
Well, first of all, I'm really looking forward to going back to Canada, to Toronto, your hometown, right? And I'm really looking forward to that buzz again and exchange with the SWIFT community. And in terms of topics, well, we've mentioned some. Of course, the whole fragmentation agenda, the G20 targets, and of course, ISO 22 are all really important. But then, of course, the macro trends when it comes to innovation, which is going to be showcased not only in NotTri, but also across the conference. AI and machine learning at the high potential. It's front and center now in every conversation and in all discussions, and how it's going to change the way we work, the way we operate, and of course, also the offerings that the industry can benefit from when it comes to anomaly detection and many more services. And we're also going to be looking at the ethical and regulatory side of AI and many more areas in innovation, particularly in InnoTribe. We'll be looking at Web 3.0 and 4.0 and 5.0 and quantum computing. And those together with definitely front and center, like it was last year, ESG and everything running from climate and financial inclusion to driving sustainable innovation.
Excellent. Thank you so much for your insights, Javier.
Well, thank you. Thank you, Joy.